Hey guys, this is Brian, aka at Quant Fiction on Twitter, and just want to talk about entries, exits, and position sizing in regards to day trading. So my approach to this topic is probably a little bit different than most that you've heard from. I think position sizing is either the most important or the only thing that you really need to worry about in your trading. So if you can think of a traditional exit and entry approach, it's no different than going from a position size of 0 to 1 in the case of an entry, or 1 to 0 in the case of an exit. For long trades, obviously, you can flip the signs negative for shorts. But that's pretty much how I think of my trading on a basic level. And so once you reframe it that way, rather than discrete entries and exits, and instead think of it in terms of positions, you really open a lot of opportunities, because unlike that binary example I gave going 1 to 0, 0 to 1, you can set a range for yourself. So 0 to 10, where 10 you're allocating the full amount of risk, and 0 you're allocating no risk, and there's a spectrum there. And I've covered in multiple articles, tried to go into some detail about position sizing and how important it is for your trading. I would say the original source, or the best source, would be Ralph Vince's books, but you can also check out my blog articles for a condensed version. But really, this changed most of how I thought about trading. Once I learned some of the math that goes into position sizing. So if you just think about it at its most basic level, if you have a coin flip where there's a 50-50 chance of winning, if you win, you double your money, and if you lose, you lose all of your money. If you think about this for a second, obviously you can't play this game, because the second you lose one time, you lose all your money. So this is a little counterintuitive, because at its face, the game looks profitable. If you win twice as much as you lose and you have a 50% chance of winning, you have a strong positive expected outcome for each coin flip. But with compounded losses and the fact that you're risking everything, this is not a profitable game to play. So if you take it down a notch, if you were to only wager half of the amount on each game, so now you win 100% or lose 50%, this is still unprofitable. I wish I had a graph to display this, but if you play this game enough times, you will eventually lose all your money. And you can replicate this thought experiment for different fractions of your overall capital or stake or position size, until you get to an optimal level. And so in this contrived example, that optimal level is about 25% of your total equity. And this is also known as the Kelly criterion, or Ralph Vince refers to it as optimal F. But this is the fraction of your capital that will maximize expected compound growth over time. So unfortunately, this number also is pretty much virtually guarantees the maximum drawdown over time as well. So if you're to trade at the full Kelly or full optimal F, theoretically, this is the most money you can make, but on the way, you're almost guaranteed to draw down to nothing before rebounding back to ultimately the maximum expected geometric growth. So what we can do instead of just a raw optimal number is set drawdown constraints. So if you once again iterate through all your possible position sizes, you'll find a point on that curve where you'll not only maximize your potential profit, but there's a certain level of confidence, or with a certain level of confidence, you can say that you won't draw down by X amount over a fixed time window. And This isn't an easy task because drawdown is a path dependent metric. So you could have 10 equity curves that all end in the same final equity, but have 10 different maximum drawdowns just by reshuffling the order of returns. If you have all the losses right off the bat and all the wins after that, you can imagine that you'll draw down pretty steeply before rallying back to the same point. Whereas if you just intersperse wins and losses, you'll have a smooth equity curve. So the technique that I tend to use is for a given set of return distributions, or a given set of returns, conduct a Monte Carlo analysis or just a random reshuffling of those returns. And while I'm doing this, I typically use a nonlinear optimization function to get to this result. Doing it brute force or just iterating through all possible combinations is going to be pretty time consuming. But essentially what you're looking to do is find the fraction of your capital to stake, or the optimal position size, where you can say with confidence that you won't draw down by a certain amount, and the maximum position size subject to that constraint is what you want to use. Now, the other facet of this is your max loss that you are either limiting with a stop loss or hedging with an option structure, or just using either a maximum historical loss multiplied by some safety factor, because typically the past or the future will always be worse than the worst we've seen in the past. But you're setting this max loss constraint so that you know you won't blow up, because basically if you're doing this procedure and you get to a position size recommendation that says that you should lever up, use 2.5 times the amount of capital you have, and your max loss is 50%, well, if you hit that max loss with 2.5 times your capital, you'll blow up. So that's another thing to keep in mind. But just briefly, again, I would recommend you check out the articles that I've posted at quantfiction.com. There's a 3-part series on position sizing specifically. And so it really walks through the process of why this is important, the basic math behind it, compounded growth, and how position size affects it, as well as a method to determine your optimal fraction, your optimal position size, subject to drawdown constraints. And then the 3rd part of that series completes the ideas in the first two and applies the same ideas to a portfolio approach and shows how correlations can play a huge impact in your trading. So this is relevant to people who trade multiple systems or trade multiple instruments, hold different strategies in a portfolio, et cetera, and how to size each of them with respect to each other. And the last thing I want to touch on, risk management. So position sizing is obviously a huge part. People will set stops or use hedges, again, like a put on a long equity position to cap their max loss. And that's important, but I think just real briefly, it's also important to discuss all the other elements that go into risk management, which is everything else in your trading business. So the trading computer you're using, do you have a uninterrupted power supply? Do you have a backup internet connection? Do you have a backup computer ready to go? Are you planning for any unforeseen consequences? Because the last thing you want to do is have a moment when you're trading live in front of the screen, you have a large position open, and you lose an internet connection, or you lose power, or some unforeseen circumstance arises where you're exposed in the market and you don't know what to do. So those are all the things you need to think about. I hope this was informative. If you have any questions, you can visit my website at quantfiction.com. Visit my Twitter page at quantfiction. And I also run a service called At Market Science. So atmarketscience.com. Please check it out if you have time. Thanks again.